Hey everyone, welcome to my show. I hope you guys are doing great. Lockdown has been partially lifted up in some cities and some cities are still under lockdown. But I'm very hopeful that soon everyone will be able to free to go out and live the new normal life again. So today's topic for the podcast is very important and my favorite topic. Should we go to college or not? So let's start. I would like to mention that having a degree and education are two different things. To get a degree, you need to go to college. But to have an education, you don't. You can get an education by any means, say like online courses, YouTube videos from an expert, and so many other things. Actually, every day when we learn something new, we are educating ourselves through different mediums. So today, I'm going to put forth an analysis that I did by putting lots of hours into researching the topic. If you ask me, what do I think? I would say you do not need a college degree to be successful in life. And I want to ask you, will you recommend anyone going to same college you went to and doing the same thing that you did? I'm pretty sure most of us will say no. Let me explain it. First of all, there are lots of successful entrepreneurs or businessmen, businesswomen in the world who did not go to college. For example, Microsoft's Bill Gates, Apple's Steve Jobs, Facebook's Mark Zuckerberg. We also have lots of such examples in India as well. Founder of Oyo, the youngest billionaire in the world, Ritesh Agarwal, never went to college. He is just 26 years old. Asia's richest man, the Mukesh Ambani, also dropped out of Stanford University and went back to India to help his father in his business. Gautam Adani dropped out of Gujarat University when he was in second year of bachelor's degree in commerce. You may say these people are exceptions. But there are also lots of people who are not billionaires but are like very successful without having a college degree. I'm sure every one of us knows such people. For example, I know a guy who earns way more than a well-experienced IT engineer from his business. And that guy has failed 10 standard. You know, in metro cities like Bangalore, Mumbai, Pune, a tea seller, a chaiwala, or a shop owner earns more money than professionals. So you can see that these people became successful in their life without having any formal educational degree. Gaining knowledge is important and not a degree. On the other hand, there are lots of people who did not go to college and are not successful in life. So not going to college for a degree is not for everyone. There might be some people who like to go to college and do the job, just like normal, happy people. Another thing is, our education system is not updated with the current trends in the industry. Most of the colleges in India or in the world are teaching the same courses with the same contents which they are teaching for the last 20 to 30 years. Even today, when I was doing research for the podcast, I found that for second year of Pune University's computer engineering, they are still teaching 8086 microprocessor, which is an electronic device, and that device is not being used since 1998. So formal education is not giving you something new or something important, and that cannot help you to excel in life and achieve success. Also, a survey did in 2019 says that 80% of engineers are not even employable. Forget about them like being competitive in the environment. Now you can imagine what kind of a degree we are getting by putting so much money and no job guarantee. I will talk more about our education system and how it is not very good and how it is shaping our lives and the future for the worse in some another episode. You might know Peter Thiel, founder of PayPal. He encourages talented students to drop out of college and start their own business. And whoever drops out of college and start their business, he provides them $100,000, around 75 lakh rupees, as a support for their business. We all know Elon Musk, CEO of Tesla and SpaceX. He went on record saying when he hires for his company, he does not even care if that guy went to college or not. He just looks for talent in a person. The another most important thing is cost of the education. In India, average cost of bachelor's degree in engineering costs around 1.5 to 2 lakh per year. That means to get an engineering degree, you have to pay around 5 to 6 lakh rupees. And that's only your fees. If you combine other expenses like your living expenses, your food and other things, an engineering degree costs around 10 to 12 lakhs for a student. And even after spending so much money, there is no guarantee of job. As per the Times of India's report in 2019, the average starting salary of an engineer in India is around 1.8 to 3 lakhs per year. With this, it takes you around, like say, 8 to 10 years to break even considering your expenses. Break even means to pay back what you paid for your education. I have even seen people working for 5,000 to 10,000 rupees per month after finishing their degrees. And with such a low income, it is very hard to buy a house or a flat which costs around 60 to 80 lakhs. And it's also very difficult to survive in a metro city, which is very expensive. And even if you buy a house by taking a loan, you keep repaying it for the rest of your life. Basically, you owe your life to that. I'm pretty sure you must have seen such a people or know them who are in this trap and cannot get out of it even if they want to. So spending so much money and getting nothing in return doesn't look like a good deal, right? Instead, you can invest the money in professional courses of your interest and easily get a well-paying job. Or you can even start a business if you want. Again, guys, I want to be clear that I'm not saying that you should not get any education at all. All I'm saying, if you have enough education and passion to do something, it should be enough for you to become successful in life. And you don't have to waste time to go to college and get a degree and follow the crowd mentality. Now let's talk about what else you can do if you don't want to go to college for a degree. You can do a course of your interest. For example, you are interested in real estate. There are lots of courses available which you can do and become a certified real estate dealer. If you are interested in some art like drawing or like creating something at home, you can even sell your products online on Amazon or any other website. If you are interested in business, you can even buy products for less and sell them for more at a location where there is a demand for it. Or you can even like start manufacturing some small products and you even get a loan for that from a bank for zero interest. You can even start coaching students for something like chess, cricket, or like table tennis or other sports that you are interested in. I'm pretty sure if you look out for ways, there are lots of ways to earn money without investing a huge amount of money to get a degree. So what do you think? Should you still go to college or not? Alright guys, that's it for today. All the best. Do let me know in the comment section what do you think about this episode and let me know the topics you want me to talk about. If you like this episode, please leave a like and share it with your friends and family. And do subscribe to our channel. Thank you guys. Bye bye. Take care.